Welcome to another episode of Global Banking Finance Review. My name is Deepika Lobo. Today we are going to talk about the truth you need to know about becoming an astronaut. Most of us as kids wanted to become astronauts. Maybe even I did. But only a handful of people have been able to fulfill their wish of becoming a professional astronaut. The passion of reaching the space is not something that can become a reality overnight. It involves years of dedicated approach, education, and experience. Despite all these efforts, many can't get through the first attempt as only a few applicants can become astronauts, making it hard to get through. So what education do you need to become an astronaut? The first thing is to have relevant experience in school. There are two main categories of astronauts applicants, military and civilian. The aspiring astronauts should have a bachelor's degree in maths, engineering, biological science, or physical science at the least. Many successful astronauts have a master's and a doctoral degree. Now coming to the most complicated part, physical fitness. Candidates have to be in a great physical shape with a 20/20 vision, a height between 62 and 75 inches for a pilot astronaut, and a height between 58.5 and 76 inches for mission control astronauts. If you're applying for a pilot astronaut post, it is recommended to have a flight test experience, should not have any diseases and is not dependent on drugs, alcohol or tobacco. The candidate should have normal functionality in all the joints. The candidate should not have any mental health issues. That was quite a long list, wasn't it? Let me continue. There will be many interviews during the selection process where the candidate will be tested physically, mentally, as well as psychologically. If you are selected after this rigorous process, you are still not considered as an astronaut as there are other procedures to complete. You will have to complete 2 years of training where you will work as an astronaut candidate. During this period, the candidate will get classroom training about the space stations and space flight. Here you will have to learn scuba diving, water survival training, swimming tests, and will be trained in atmospheric pressures of varying degrees, high and low. You will also be trained in Russian language, conduct flights in Vomit Comet, and much more. Post the graduation, the astronauts will still not be assigned flights, and it may take years before they are sent. Till then, they have to work as backups to other astronauts in orbits, work in NASA and other partners like Canada, and earn to operate the robotic arm. They are also expected to be proficient on T-38 aircraft and have minimum hours of flying time per month. Did you want to become an astronaut when you were a child? How hard did you think it was? Let us know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, don't forget to subscribe, like and comment. And one lucky winner will win a 1-year free subscription of Global Banking and Finance Review magazine.